I'm not gonna count them as they come out.
Too many to count.
And we're lonely here tonight.
Great crowd. I mean, this is a football game type crowd.
We've had a few like this. The new Red Devil Hill. And they'll be ready for football here in a couple of months. We'll be on the road for the first, at least three games. First game can be in Lovejoy. That's going to be a Thursday game.
All right.
So we'll be starting off the year on a Thursday night in Clayton County.
Just about to get our Facebook live stream started, so you can turn up your radio and you can turn this on at the same time. Let's see the seniors taking their seats. Try to get a little zoom in here.
Yeah. Sounds like the final quarter at a winning football game here at Red Devil Hill.
Oh yeah, we're gonna have a lot of those come to fall. Facebook Live. Seems to have been fickle right now. So that's the good thing, again, if this doesn't go through on Facebook Live, then you know what? That's all right. Like I said, you can go back to our YouTube page and watch it anytime. So we're going to try to going again. Alright, let's see if that works. Yeah, sometimes it wants to have connection issues, but
that's a bit of
always have backup for backup.
I love technology.
And they are filing into their seats.
Turn that field lock down a little bit there. Wow. Through the list of graduating seniors, and a lot of them are athletes. Of course, they're going to be from the athletics here. We have a little, we've got several from both baseball and the football side, but basketball also. We're going to be graduating out of the youth basketball
competition. The sun is beginning to set, so we're shooting for a nice evening.
That's probably this Friday too. I think, think that's the first time I've ever seen the Give It a Shot story.
I did manage to get some good pictures of any of our listeners have it driven by or not right in the area. So I think we'll see what the field looks like, what's going on. I took some earlier when we got here, and I'll be posting those later on. So this Facebook Live seems to be going pretty strong right now. So checking into our Facebook site, WJZ92.1, and you should be able to go on and see the same thing we're seeing right now. As long as it keeps me to cooperate, and it looks like it is right now. And like I said, filming this as well, got the camera set up, so it will be uploaded to our YouTube page, which you can link to on our webpage. One way or another. Yeah, everything seems to be going good so far.
We'll see here.
Better too many than not. When I graduated it rained the morning. We had our practice that morning, but it rained earlier that night and early in the morning. So when we got there for practice, all the seats were full of water.
Before the event of artificial turf and all the football fields were always kind of muddy and
I was the only one that, for whatever reason, thought it was a good idea to bring a towel.
All right, we're about ready to get things underway here. We're going to turn off our mics and we're going to turn it up on the field.
First grade class, formed at my best friend and future college roommate, Mallory Porter, Ms. Good evening. On behalf of the Bus Men of Action, I would like to present this scholarship to Jayla Barkley.
Good evening. On behalf of the Butts County Chamber of Commerce, I would like to present a scholarship to Hayden Smith.
Good
Brenton Edwards. And Mallory Britton.
In memory of my father, the late Reverend C.F. Thurman Sr., I would like to present three scholarships to three very deserving seniors. Ms. Shamira King, Ms. Unity McClendon, and Mr. Xavier Cash.
West Georgia University. University of West Georgia. I'd like to present the Cross Scholarship and the amount of $64,000 over 4 years to the Cameron. $140,000. Senior McCutcheon.
Thank you. and Mallory Harper.
On behalf of the Butts County NAACP, number 5204, we are pleased to present two scholarships. The first scholarship will go to Shamiri Key.
Good evening. I would like to take a moment to honor a member of the class of 2020.
2022, here student Queen, that passed away her freshman year, and I would also like to welcome her family and friends that are in attendance tonight. Please observe a moment of silence for Kirsten Queen. Thank you. I would like to welcome Superintendent Brent Lowe, our distinguished Board of Education, our community partners, faculty, parents, families, and our students to our newly renovated Red Devil Hill. In just a few minutes, the class of 2022 will receive diplomas to mark their graduation from high school. The one word that I would use to describe this class is connected. Back in 2018, I challenged this class to connect to their high school. Connect by joining a club, the band, drama, chorus, NJRTC, a sports team, anything. Just connect to your school and you will have a great school experience. Not only did this class show up and join up, they also are some of the student leaders that began our student leadership group, RD4L. Seniors, I want to thank you for your leadership and all you meant to Jackson High School over the last 4 years. Let's give them a hand. During the last couple of years, this class had to face the adversity that COVID brought to the world. However, due to their connectedness to their school and school culture, our students, teachers, and parents persevered and continue to move the educational dial forward together. The result? A graduating class of 229. Of the 229, 127 are off to college, 6 are joining a job program, 20 are joining Youth Apprenticeship, 9 are committed to the military, and 23 are headed to a vocational school. That's 185 members of this class have a defined path after tonight's commencement. We can't wait to hear all you will accomplish throughout the next phases of your life. At this time, I would like to recognize those well-deserving students that are receiving state-level scholarships. First, we'd like to acknowledge and acknowledge all of our graduates who are entering the armed forces. As I call your name, please stand and be recognized that you're entering the armed forces after graduation. These students are Jesse Gilmore, Navy. Olivia Gilmore, Air Force. Alistair Baldwin, Anthony DeCedric, Michael Richardson, Alexis Cook, Emily Trimble, Mallory Carter, Harley Waits, Eric Zuniga, and Maggie Shields. Thank you, seniors. Each year, some Jackson High School students choose to take advantage of the opportunities available through Move On When Ready initiative. This is a chance to take college courses and earn both high school graduation, but they are beginning their college career at the same time. Jackson High School has two students who have gone above and beyond the normal dual enrollment accomplishments. This evening, we have two students that have already graduated with an associate's degree from Gordon State College. It is my pleasure to recognize Mr. Michael Richardson. Thank you. The class of 2022 also has three Reach Scholars graduating this year. The Reach Georgia Scholarship rewards students for self-accountability, promotes parent involvement, and provides motivation and support. All factors that we know are critical in student educational achievement. I would like to thank our parents, our mentors, and our community partners who provided the necessary funds to make this scholarship possible. This is a four-year commitment that these three students met. Our Reach Scholars for the class of 2022 are Tanaya McCutcheon, Alyssa Travis, Eric Zuniga. The Star Student Award is given to the senior who meets three qualifications set by Page Foundation. They must be a resident of the state of Georgia, rank in the top 10% of their class at the end of their junior year, and achieve the highest SAT score in their graduating class. This year's Star Student recipient is Eric Zuniga. Total scholarship amount for this class are: the Hope and Sales Scholarship will provide approximately $2.1 million over the next 4 years towards college tuition for eligible seniors for the class of 2022. Local and private scholarships have been awarded to the class of 2022 seniors in the amount of $46,800. University scholarships have been offered to our seniors totaling an amount of approximately $1.2 million. In sum, the class of 2022 is eligible to receive approximately over $3.5 million over the next 4 years towards alleviating their college expenses. In conclusion, we will recognize the class of 2022 valedictorian. I'm sorry, the salutatorian award goes to the student who has earned the second highest cumulative academic grade point average for all 4 years of high school. The salutatorian award for the class of 22 was awarded to Ms. Alexis Cook. In conclusion, we will recognize the class of 2022 valedictorian. This honor is bestowed upon a senior that has earned the highest cumulative grade point average for all 4 years of coursework and ranked number one in his or her graduating class. The recipient, and about to speak, is our 22 valedictorian, Mallory Carter.
Regardless of who you are, why you are here, or where you come from. Matthew, after different speed limits, methods of travel, obstacles, and endings. But ultimately, our goal is the same: to find our unique, narrow path and end the race of life well. Something a man far wiser than I once said was that he did not want to finish the race of life strongly, but rather he wanted to finish it well. I used to, and still do, frequently find myself trying to take a route that others would be proud that I took. What I have come to realize is that we are not destined to take the same road as someone else. A road exists for each of us if we'll simply take the steps to follow it. Class of 2022, we have made it. This is the method we dream of our whole lives. The world is at our fingertips, and we can be the generation who changes it for the better. Might we live our lives submitted to purposes far greater than ourselves and never forget the roots we have planted here. We should strive for a life led to its fullest and one that has no regrets. So live boldly, spontaneously, and genuinely. Live in a way that fulfills all of your dreams and that makes you and your village proud. I challenge each of you to realize you are deeply loved, worthy, and precious to a perfect king who came to earth and defeated the grave for you and me. All roads have led us here, to this place, to this moment in time. Celebrate this victory tonight, and as tomorrow begins, have confidence when you wake up an accomplished graduate. Whatever road you take, you have the power to pursue one that changes the trajectory of your life. Thank you.
new diplomas. We're waiting for the alma mater.